What does the yield curve at this point tell us about monetary policy at the Fed?
Well, thanks, Paul, for having me on. I thought that President George Esther said, summarized it very well at the very end there, that the Fed is not trying to target the yield curve. You try to use it as a signal of what's going on in the economy. I think it's, in the past, it's been correlated with recessions, and so you have to take it on board as a signal of a potential recessionary risk. And I think it'll be, certainly an important but not necessarily determinative input into your thinking as a policymaker.
So if you're back on the Fed right now, what would this yield curve in this circumstance in 2018 be telling you, and how would you react to it? Is it a different message than perhaps it was 5 years ago?
Yeah, I think one of the challenges with the yield curve is that we have a strong correlative pattern in the data, but we don't really, as macroeconomists, have a great modeling or theoretical understanding of what that causal mechanism is. So that means that you come to 2018 and you're not sure whether or not that correlative pattern that's been there in the past data is still going to be there. And I think President Mester spoke to why you might think that it's not going to be as important. Having said that, I think it's a signal of potential recessionary risk that I think the Fed should be taking on board in terms of setting the path of rate hikes, and it's a reason why the path of rate hikes should be lower and slower than maybe otherwise.
Which raises the question, if the yield curve isn't necessarily telling us a clear signal, are other monetary policy models not as well? And this raises what Fed Powell talked about earlier on Friday. He said the U-star is the natural rate of unemployment, R-star is the neutral real rate of interest, and Pi-star is the inflation objective. According to conventional thinking, policymakers should navigate by these stars. In that sense, they are very much akin to celestial stars. Do you agree that the traditional models just don't work, that the Phillips curve can't be looked at as a signal for how and when to hike hike rates?
Well, I'm an economist, and so I took a slightly different message from what Chairman Powell was saying, which is that there's uncertainty about R-star and U-star, and you've got to take those uncertainties on board when you're making policy. And that I totally agree with that. You shouldn't be treating Pi-star as uncertain because, the Fed's determined Pi-star for itself as being 2%. But the absolutely. We had long conversations. Even in the midst of very high unemployment, we were having conversations about what exactly U-star was. When unemployment was 10%, many, including myself, worried that U-star had risen. And now there's, I think, reasonable questions about, well, maybe U-star can be much lower than it's been historically. So I think that I thought Chairman Powell's speech was right on point, that you don't just use one model and one specification of these parameters. You've got to go out and think about the uncertainties associated with them.
So Narayana, if you listen at the very beginning to St. Louis Fed President Bullard, he was saying, I'm not sure I want to pay as much attention to the models as to my own personal experience. I was there in 2000, was there in 2006, and it didn't work out so well when we hiked into an inverted yield curve. Is he right that this is a time we have to rely more on experience than some of the academic or economic models?
I thought that those experiences are ones that are material, but the point of the models, the models are an attempt to build in many pieces of information beyond perhaps one person's remembrance of their experience. And they're not, I think there's an overly sharp line drawn between theory and data. Theory, it comes from data. Models come from data. So they're an attempt to draw upon many sources of information. Those get summarized in these numbers like U-star and R-star. And so I, if I were still a policymaker, absolutely I'd be paying attention to what happened in 2000, 2006, and President Bullard is right to draw our attention to those episodes. But they're not the final word by any means. You also want to be paying attention to the fact that, boy, unemployment's pretty low compared to where it's been historically, and we have this big fiscal policy change in the part of the administration and Congress, and we've got to take that into account as well.